Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around smart home devices. In this video, we will see how to flash smart light bulbs manufactured by Tuya, a Chinese company that is sold by many brands with their own branding. And the devices mostly use ESP8266. The smart bulb I have got is sold by Wipro in India, and this particular light has got brightness and temperature control. We are going to flash the bulb with Tasmota, which is a popular open source firmware meant for ESP8266 and other such controllers for home automation. By doing this, the bulb can be made independent of internet and can be controlled from any device in the local network, which in my case is going to be OpenHAF and Node-RED. To control the device, I'll be using MQTT. However, before flashing the device, make sure you are using a Tuya device. You can check this by checking in the API calls made by the device. The API calls can be checked by using any proxy tools such as Charles Proxy. And be careful while flashing the device as it may brick your device. To flash Tasmota to the bulb, I'm going to use Tuya Convert that lets us flash the bulb without using any hardware connectivity. And to do so, we need a Raspberry Pi with Wi-Fi connectivity, a smartphone, and the device to be flashed, which in our case is the smart bulb. One more thing guys, while flashing, just be careful, because if anything goes wrong, it can make the device useless. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, I have connected my Pi to the network and now it is running the latest version of Raspbian, and I am using the light version of it. Now let's first SSH to the Pi, but to do so you need to enable SSH in the Pi, which can be done by simply creating a file named SSH without any extension to the put partition. The tool we are going to use to flash Tasmota is Tuya Convert, and the installation procedure is pretty simple. So let's first SSH to the device. Yep. And I'll just open up the Tuya Convert repository, and I'll be providing the link to this particular repository over here in the description down below. So you can go ahead and pretty much check like the instructions are clear and are pretty simple. So what we need to do is we need to clone this repository and follow the instructions in the Pi. So to clone the repository, I'll first install Git to my like Raspberry Pi. To do so, I'll just first update, because if this installation and one more thing over here, the Raspberry Pi that you are using must have Wi-Fi to make this work. Now I'll just install Git. Now we can just copy this particular git clone command, or we can just copy this URL and use git clone. Okay, the installation of Git is done. So now just click over here, git clone, and the URL of the repository. This might take few seconds. Now after the repository is cloned, let's get into it and we need to run the install prerequisite script. So this will like particularly install all the dependencies, so this might take some time, so let's just wait for it. So finally the installation is done. Now just press ls over here, and if you get into files, come over here, we'll find different the binaries available over here. So by default it has this Tasmota and Espruna firmware, but you can change this, but I'll just say go ahead with the default one for time being. And later we can upgrade to the latest one. So now after this we need to run the start a flash.sh file or script particularly, but before that we need to put the bulb into like pairing mode. So to do so, we just need to connect the bulb to any wall socket and switch it on and off for 3 times, so it will get into pairing mode. So when the bulb actually gets into pairing mode, it will start blinking. Now we can do like start with running this particular script to start the flash. Just a minute. Why? Okay, this will start up an access point that is BitTrust. So we need to connect our smartphone to that access point that is being broadcasted by the Raspberry Pi. So in my phone over here, I'll just open up Wi-Fi. Yep. It got connected automatically because earlier I just connected. So BitTrust flash. Now, and again, they will blink fast. This is also done. Now we'll enter. Okay. And right now it is doing the firmware backup, so it like backs up the like original firmware, so in case you need, you can reflash it. So over here we have got these options to flash like Aspirina or test motor, or we can quit or you can return to stock. So I'll go ahead with test motor. So I'll hit 2 and yes. So that's flashed. Now we can put. Okay, I don't want any other device, so I'll press N exit. So we have successfully flashed the bulb with test motor firmware. And if you want to, like as I said earlier also, if you want to like flash with the latest version and all, you can simply get into files folder and replace this particular testmotor.bin file, or you can add other files also over here or the custom firmwares. So let's see in our smartphone if we are getting the test motor device. Yeah, you can see over here we have got this test motor 5714. So I'll just go ahead and connect to it here. Now what I can do is I can go ahead to a new browser format, let's say Chrome or something, and I'll just navigate to the default IP that any test motor device takes, that is 192.168.4.1. Yeah, so we have got over here. So this Wi-Fi and all. So I'll just enter my Wi-Fi credentials. There is home underscore. WG and the IP1 password. I don't want second access point, so I'll just let it as it is. Now configuration is saved and device will restart. Okay, after the bulb is connected to the Wi-Fi, let's find out the address or IP address taken by it. So that I'll simply get into my router. And over here, the test motor 5714. This is the IP address that has been taken by the device or the bulb over here. You can find your IP address by getting into your router, or you can find out the IP address by using any sort of like IP scanning tool. So I'll just go ahead and click enter. Then the first thing that I'll be doing is configuring MQTT So here my host is, yeah, this one. User is the password, and topic will be 2v5, and for me it is going to be home slash the IP address. Right now I have not configured like static IP, but usually I do like use static IP. That way I'll make sure that I can hit the device always by using the IP. Otherwise you need to go again and search for the IP address like every time you want to configure it. So for me the topic is something like home, then the IP address, and then prefix. So home, so on off the IP address, and the topic. Topic is over here. This is 2F5. Okay, just I'll go ahead and save it. Again, get into main menu. Now I just need to configure the GPIOs and all. For that I'll just get into configuration, configure other, and we need to change this template. And if you want to get the template for your device, you can get it from this particular website that provides your Tasmota templates. So for me, my bulb is Wipro Garnet, this 9 watt CCD bulb. So I'll just go ahead and copy this template, come over here, paste it, click on activate, save. Now ideally when we get into the interface, we should be able to control the bulb. Okay, now toggle. Yep, that seems to be working. Now let's just try to control. Yep, it can be toggled. I can change the color temperature, and as well we can change the brightness. So I'll just do this. This is cold and full brightness. Okay, we have configuration. So we are not going to use this particular interface. So let's check out from like by using MQTT if we are successfully like able to control or what. So I'll just send 0 over here. I've just added the topic, and I'm using MQTT lens over here to communicate with the device. And you can see with this topic power and all, it is, I'm able to toggle. Now let's say we want to dim and dim it to 0, so it should be off, but when I give 100 it should be up. Then we can change the color temperature, and let's say 0 should be this, and I can give 100. Okay, color temperature seems to have some other this. One second. Oh, it has to be like 3/4. The value it takes is usually 347, 350, 400, 500. So let's say I give 500, becomes yellowish when I give 0. Or 200, let's say. Yep, it becomes white. So the minimum value is 153, and that makes it turn off. So let's say 170. So like this you can send commands by using MQTT, and moreover you can integrate with OpenHive or any other smart home like solution that you are using, and you can control the bulb locally. So for command details and all regarding Tasmota, you can head over to Tasmota website and get into Tasmota documentation, and you'll find everything over here. Or if I'll just drop the links down below in the description. So that's all, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it. If so, hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed yet, consider subscribing it. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.